I move on to leaders' questions, and I call on Deputy Micheál Martin.
Thank you, Kevin Corlin. Taoiseach, I think all of us in this House would hold the peace process dear, and particularly since the conclusion of the Good Friday Agreement, I think there's a genuine cross-party desire that we would maintain momentum towards peace and, in particular, advancing political stability within Northern Ireland. I'm sure you will agree that recent events in themselves have caused a lot of concern in terms of a genuine sense of drift in terms of both respect for the institutions within Northern Ireland and indeed for the onward momentum of the peace process itself and the institutions under the Good Friday Agreement. And in the first instance, Taoiseach, I think the withdrawal of the leaders of unionism from the talks process in relation to the past flags and parading is in many ways a sign of profound political failure now. That the decision of an independent statutory parades commission is one that has caused the First Minister and others to leave the talks and to begin a graduated response of protests. And it raises a number of fundamental questions. One, the manner in which parading is adjudicated within Northern Ireland itself. And are both governments now looking afresh at that, even in the context of the Haas talks, where the emerging momentum had been to move parading into a political office, First Minister and Deputy First Minister's office, to decide and arbitrate, and away from an independent parades commission. And secondly, the political recognition of the primacy of the rule of law. In other words, that the leading politicians in the North feel that irrespective of whether an adjudication comes from an independent institution or not, they feel free at any whim to protest at that and to remove themselves from the talks process or indeed from the North-South Ministerial Council last week. And it's not just unionist leaders. Indeed, we had this in terms of the PSNI in policing. When Deputy Adams was arrested, for example, Sinn Féin said that its support for policing was now questionable or could be threatened if he wasn't released, and that happened in a previous occasion as well when somebody was arrested. So that idea of political recognition of the primacy of law is central, I think, to political stability in Northern Ireland, Taoiseach. And I would ask for you to comment on that. But fundamentally, and I know you've had meetings with various parties, you've had talks with British Prime Minister David Cameron. Is it the view of the government now that you're going to become re-engaged in a hands-on way with the process in Northern Ireland? And particularly in the context of the talks on the past parading flags and such like, in order to inject fresh momentum into a process which has, I think, illustrated a dangerous sense of drift in recent years.
I thank Deputy Martin for his comments and for his question. I have to say that I am very concerned about the escalation of events in Northern Ireland in the recent past. In fact, in one day last week, we saw a unionist withdrawal from the Parades Commission, a withdrawal from the all-party talks, and withdrawal from the North-South Ministerial Council. This is a matter of very serious implications. I note that the unionist parties announced a graduated response, whatever is meant by that, and the first indication here was in regard to the non-attendance at the North-South Ministerial Council. It is true to say, Deputy Martin, I think the whole House should be concerned about the potential for an escalation into conflict and unwanted violence on the 12th of July, with particular reference to the flashpoint that could occur at the shops on the Ardoyne Road. To that end, I spoke to Prime Minister Cameron on Sunday and discussed this matter with him by telephone for a number of minutes in regard to the need for both governments to be very vigilant here as to what contingency plans might be put in place. I've advised the Prime Minister that I would send over the senior personnel from the departments here to London this week to engage with their counterparts. Yesterday evening I spoke to David Ford of the Alliance Party in respect of justice matters in Northern Ireland. He's obviously quite concerned about this. Last evening I also met with the SDLP party and the Sinn Féin party to get their views on the need for rational thinking now and clear heads in respect of the next period up ahead, and also the implications of what lies out ahead in September and October. The Prime Minister, for his part, has made it clear that while he is supportive and his government of the Good Friday Agreement and the process, that the executive and the parties in Northern Ireland had negotiated for and worked for and were eventually given the devolved authority for a whole range of activities with the executive, and it's to make that system work is the challenge. I regret very much that the unionist parties, both DUP and UUP, appear to have moved from a position of centrality with the Good Friday Agreement to a point somewhere right of that. I also note that some of the unionist groupings have called for peaceful measures at this weekend, and I do hope that that's what will be the consequence or the outcome of this weekend's parades and marches. I agree with you. When an independent parades commission with its independent and statutory authority makes a decision, that decision should be complied with. Parties that I spoke to yesterday, the SDLP and Sinn Féin, both indicated that they would have been supportive of the parades commission irrespective of the decision that it made. This has the potential for serious conflict this weekend. I do hope that calmer minds will see to it that that doesn't happen. The PSNI, for their part, have said that they will implement the law insofar as the Parades Commission decision is concerned. Insofar as the involvement of the British government is concerned, I've had requests to make contact with the United States as well in regard to continuing to keep a focus on having the agreement implemented in full and pushed forward. For now, I just want you to know, and thank you for your question, we are very conscious of the potential implications of this. We are in contact with the British government and contact with the Northern Ireland parties, and I do hope that that those involved here will see to it that that there is no escalation of violence or outrageous behaviour like has happened on a number of occasions. It is potentially very serious.
Deputy Martin.
Thank you, Taoiseach, for his reply. I just want to put it to you, Taoiseach, that there is a need for you and the British Prime Minister to meet urgently, in my view, and then in consultation with the parties in Northern Ireland, to draw up a framework to create fresh momentum in terms of the political situation in Northern Ireland and to create a new agenda to move the process onwards. There was a Community Relations Council report in the Northern Assembly this week, which was quite disturbing in terms of the revelations concerning, if you could call them revelations, concerning the significant underachievement in education, in health and in social areas for a very significant population of West and North Belfast, and particularly among particular groupings there. Very, very damning statistics, and a very, very worrying situation in terms of the future of those areas, in terms of the young people there, and young males in particular, having a sense of engagement with society, a sense of a future and ownership in that society, in terms of education, participation, in terms of employment, and so on. So looking at the medium term, even if one gets over this very difficult phase, there's absolutely an urgent need on behalf of both governments to up the game, so to speak, in terms of the level of their engagement, and to create a new agenda for driving forward stability within Northern Ireland, which involves a socio-economic dimension as well. I put that to Taoiseach in good faith. And also I would ask you, have you, and the Prime Minister made it clear to all of the political leaders in Northern Ireland, that they can't pick and choose in terms of political recognition of the primacy of the rule of law, whether it's the decisions of the PSNI in prosecuting particular cases, or indeed the Parades Commission in terms of the independent adjudication it may make on particular parades. That it's not on for the First Minister and it's not on for the Deputy First Minister to decide when they show confidence in those institutions or not. Because their performance in recent times, I think, has undermined public confidence in shared institutions. It took a lot of work to build those institutions up. And what do we expect the public to expect if the leaders aren't behaving in a responsible and reasonable manner?
I agree that in some cases there seems to be a feeling of utter hopelessness and despair about where this is now appeared to be headed. For that reason, I asked the Prime Minister to consider speaking to the First Minister. He was to speak to the Secretary of State. I can't confirm whether he spoke to the DUP leader or not. I note the report that you mentioned about the implications of the consequences of this for young people, for education and so on. There's also the decision to be made in respect of welfare reform, which would, you know, have a substantial cutback in finance for facilities of up to 650 million, which clearly is has implications for the executive and the way it goes about its business. But also, and that was partly the reason why extra monies were put in under the Peace 4 agreement arising from the presidency last year to deal with those sensitive communities that you mentioned. I don't have any difficulty arranging a meeting with the British Prime Minister if that's necessary. I did agree with him on Sunday that we would both from here and London continue to monitor this very closely and to engage with the parties, and I committed myself to that in the meetings and the discussions that I had yesterday.
Thank you.
I myself haven't spoken directly to the First Minister. Obviously, I recommended that the Prime Minister would engage with him in the first instance, but it is a case of hoping to get through this weekend without any escalation of violence and make contingency arrangements for what is best for the future. This is a sensitive period, as you're well aware, and clearly the period up ahead between September and Christmas is crucial for the putting back on track of the peace process and the move to implement fully the Good Friday Agreement.
Thank you.